As universe was sleeping, somewhere in the universe, there was a fight amongst the clans going on for the survival of mankind, survival of soul, survival of all living bodies. Mythology says Mandara mountain was used as a churning machine with the help of snake god Vasuki. Two clans were involved in the churning to get the life-saving nectar, Amrita. But before that, deadly poison, Halahal, emerged, and it was all held by Lord Shiva in his throat, Neelkantha. As Amrita emerged, few drops fell in few places of our country, India. Astrologically, it is said that when Leo enters Venus and Aries, Jupiter and Venus are aligned, that is the exact time when these drops fell. These drops were considered immortal. One such drop fell in Ujjain, the city of Mahakal. That is how the festival of elixir began.
ये जो भूमि है ना उज्जैन, ये बहुत ही पवित्र भूमि है। सिंहस्थ का मतलब सूर्य जब सिंह राशि में आता है वहाँ पर 12 वर्ष के साल सिंह राशि में पदार्पण सूर्य का होता है और ये 12 साल के बाद यहाँ पर सिंहस्थ कुंभ
What I discover is that the color of the robe doesn't really, today is not so much what I'm looking for. It's meeting people's soul. So what I like in the kumbh is that quite a lot of people are coming and there is a particular feeling of joy.
Kumbh. The Kumbh Mela. It is believed that whoever takes a dip in this holy river during this period finds freedom, finds mukti. Freedom from all troubles, desires. Freedom for everybody has a different meaning.
Chanda Suraj ki jyoti hai mata kesh ghata maharani ran chali bhavani.
In era of Mahabharata, mukti or moksh was the primitive motto of human life. The concept of moksh has evolved from mythology towards today's world.
Jab mind ko focus karte hain to jab फोकस में माइंड की जो एनर्जी है सिर्फ 5 से 10% खर्च होती है, बाकी एनर्जी हमारे ब्रेन में डायरेक्ट आती है और ब्रेन के थ्रू स्पाइनल कॉर्ड से होते हुए पूरे बॉडी में फैल जाते हैं। तो बॉडी में एनर्जी फैलने से क्या होता है, बॉडी फ्लेक्सिबल हो जाता है, रिलैक्स हो जाता है और पूरे सेल्स को एनर्जी मिल जाती है। आज के डेट में बॉडी को एनर्जी क्यों नहीं मिलती है, क्योंकि मन में क्या है, स्ट्रेस है, भय है, चिंता है, तो ये 90% एनर्जी खा जाता है। 10% ब्रेन को मिलता है, बॉडी को, तो बॉडी के मसल्स स्टिफ हो जाते हैं। इसीलिए लोग कहते हैं चिंता चीता के समान है।
We are moving towards a hectic lifestyle, leaving behind the essence of our soul and searching freedom.
After I do this, I will get happy, I will get that particular thing, then I will be happy. So what we are doing? Unknowingly, we are postponing our happiness. A person who postpones the happiness, even God cannot make him happy. God will say, "Chalo happy ho, nahi kal." Tomorrow, not today. These are things you don't get in books. You just observe your own life. We have no choice but to live in the present. Clear? Can you live yesterday? Can you live tomorrow? No.
Ujjain and Kumbh catch the imagination of people around the world. It is said every 12 years this Kumbh happens.
Kumbh भारत की सनातन परंपरा में एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण स्थान रखता है, इन द सेंस कि चार स्थलों पर, हरिद्वार में, नासिक में, प्रयागराज में और उज्जैन में, ये 12 वर्षों के अंतराल में ये उत्सव आता है और इसको इस तरह से संयोजित किया गया है कि हर तीसरे वर्ष कहीं न कहीं भारत के किसी न किसी एक हिस्से में, इन चार शहरों में से कुंभ हो रहा हो। इसका मुख्य उद्देश्य ये था कि तीन तीन वर्षों के अंतराल में एक तरह से मध्यावधि समीक्षा होती रहे उन सब चीज़ों के संदर्भ में जो कि कुंभ में रहते हुए अपने समय और समाज की समस्याओं के बारे में पंडितों और विद्वानों ने जो भी कुछ निर्णित किया होगा उस सबका जो है अर्थ निकाल कर ये देखा जाता रहे कि इनमें उन प्रतिज्ञाओं के बारे में, उन सहमतियों के बारे में, उन सर्वानुमतियों के बारे में आखिरकार समाज ने किस हद तक प्रगति की है। तो ये एक लक्ष्य कुंभ का हमेशा से रहा है और इसलिए कुंभ को सिर्फ हम आध्यात्मिक जो स्नान की चीज़ें नहीं मानते, हम लोग मानते हैं कि ये ध्यान, धारणा, समाधि का क्षेत्र भी था और विचार का भी, चिंतन और अनुचिंतन का भी क्षेत्र था। तो इसलिए कुंभ में जब कोई आता है तो वो सिर्फ स्नात होकर ही नहीं जाता, स्नातक होकर भी जाता था। और कुंभ में सिर्फ दर्शन ही नहीं मिलते थे बल्कि दर्शन भी मिलता था, फलसफा मिलता था, विचार मिलता था।
The crowd was spread across. If we see the historical revolution of Ujjain, the first Kumbh was held in 1695. Thereafter, it has been taken over by Maratha ruler Ranoji Shinde. We found evidence in the Vikrama Smriti Grantha. Earlier, people used to gather here to exchange their views and then return to their places. This Mela also acts as ground for public to become sannyasis or bairagis. When we compare the four centuries, a notable difference is that Ujjain Mela was not called a Kumbh Mela until 19th century. Maratha era. According to the Vikrama Smriti Grantha, published by the Vikram University, the Ujjain Simhastha began when the Maratha ruler Ranoji Shinde invited Akharas from Nasik to Ujjain for a local festival of uncertain origin. In 1789, after a clash between Shaivite sannyasis and Vaishnavite Bairagis at Trimbak, the Maratha Peshwa ordered the two groups to bathe at separate places.
Jo Indore mein rehta uska connection Ujjain ke saath to ho hi jata hai. This is called a magical city. It's also a spiritual city. It's a very ancient city. And there's so much to learn here in Ujjain. बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलता है, बहुत सारे अच्छे लोग मिलते हैं. Ujjain is one of the important spiritual centers of India. It is a center for tantra. It is a center for meditation. It has got amazing temples ranging from the Mahankaleshwar temple to Chintamani Ganesh to Harsati Mata. Yahan hazaron hazaron temples hain, each with its own significance. There are many places which are not that famous which are fascinating. Jaise ek यहाँ एक इलक के ऊपर एक गोरखनाथ जी का टेम्पल है जो एक महासंत थे. बहुत बहुत कम लोग जाते हैं बट दैट टेम्पल हैज़ गॉट एन ऑरा विच इज ऑसम. सिट देयर ऑलमोस्ट इंस्टेंटली अ पर्सन लाइक हु मेडिटेट्स कैन गेट लॉस्ट इन मेडिटेशन. वेरी वेरी गुड वाइब्रेशन. अगर आप आपकी इस विजिट पे उसे जाके देख सकते हैं टेम्पल को, थोड़ा सा ध्यान भी लगाएं तो आप भाग नहीं सकते। सबसे पहला पहलू है कि दे वांट मोक्ष, दूसरी बात है दैट दे सीक आउट सीयर्स एंड सेंट्स फ्रॉम होम दे कैन लर्न सिस्टम्स ऑफ मेडिटेशन, दे वांट टू मीट सेंट्स फ्रॉम होम दे कैन हैव अ क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन बाय विच सो मेनी ऑफ देयर अनआंसर्ड क्वेश्चंस कैन बी आंसर्ड, बिकॉज दिस इज अ प्लेस, एक ही वक्त एक ही महीने में जो बहुत सारे हमारे संत गुरु हैं उनके अखाड़ों के साथ इंडिविजुअल लेवल पे गुप्त लेवल पे यहाँ आते हैं और जो श्रद्धालुओं से मिलते हैं एंड देर इज एन एक्सचेंज ऑफ नॉलेज।
ड्यूरिंग द ब्रिटिश रूल द उज्जैन सिंहस्थ वॉज द ओनली कुंभ मेला ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इन अ प्रिंसली स्टेट। During this time, the Sindhias financed half of the event's expenses. At the 1826 fair in Ujjain, a sectarian conflict took place between the Saivite Gosais and the Vaishnavite Bairagis. The Gosais, who started the clash, were defeated. The 1921 Simhastha is notable for a historic debate in which the Ramanandi Sampradaya defeated the Ramanuja Sampradaya. The debate was to address the question whether the Sri Vaishnava literature offended Ramachandra. The Ramanuja Sampradaya was defended by Swami Rama Prapan Ramanuja Das of the Tota Drimat. The Ramanandis were represented by Bhagavatacharya. The jury declared Bhagavatacharya as the winner of the debate. India got its freedom in 1947. But even today, people are searching for actual freedom, moksha. People come over here in sake of moksha. People come over here to meet new people. People come over here for a magical and mystical experience. The commercialization has taken a new leap altogether. The festival of elixir is no longer known for the festival of soul. It is more about exchanging ideas as it was derived in Vedas earlier. In every corner, you will see huge hoardings of some or the other company advertising their products. As our eyes followed billboards, we saw Computer Baba, Pilot Baba, Golden Baba, and many more. We were in a fix that we are in an era of media explosion, but later realized those were put on by the followers. World is a global village, and as we surf through the global information band, we gain whatever information we look for. The concept of Kumbh festival was similar as of today's virtual information bank, where Kumbh was a platform for gaining knowledge and information through interaction with fellow humans. That's why it is also perceived as the largest festival of mankind and humanity. A place to meet and greet for an entire month without any foundation, without any stature, without any purpose, without any expectation, just to gain knowledge deep within. A convocation field for Maharishis is now becoming a convocation platform for life seekers. 2016 Ujjain Simhastha Kumbh Festival was so well managed festival which has not only included innovative ideas on the ground, but also provided knowledge to the world. The changing trends of human life have evolved and changed this mythological event as a platform for the people to come and exchange their ideas, share their knowledge, plan for better society and life as it was in Vedic era. The Mela ground is now vacant. all the ashramas, societies, akhadas have gone, leaving a space, a hope behind for freedom. Freedom from violence, freedom from darkness, freedom from ill thoughts, freedom from social barriers, and fly high towards life to attain ultimate freedom through innovations, through imaginations, through science, through the law of universe, moksha. The 2016 Ujjain Kumbh Mela has been planned since last 2 years and was well managed. Government has taken fields from farmers and they have compensated them with the amount which is equivalent to productivity of whole 2 years. Within 1 month, the structures were removed while construction and laying out began 6 months before. All the structures were temporary, either of cloth or jute or of other handmade materials. Sewerage system was also on the place. As technology has evolved, Narmada's water was diverted to Ujjain for flawless dips and Kumbh rituals. An estimated 75 million people attended the Mahakumbh Mela 2016 in Ujjain. Anyone visiting the Kumbh Mela can witness a diversified crowd that includes various types of holy men, Naga sadhus, or the naked holy monks of India, Urdhavahurs, who perform rituals that include putting the body through severe austerities, Parivrajakas, who travel around places, Maunis, who don't speak at all and taken a vow of silence, Shirshasinis, who stand 24 hours on their head and meditate. Kalpavasis are the ones who bathe thrice a day. The management of the largest festival on earth creates 65,000 jobs directly or indirectly. A team of around 50,000 police officials manage the grand crowd during Kumbh. 30 temporary police chowkis are also created to combat security issues.
दरअसल जब वायु में पूरी सौर मंडल में जब नक्षत्रों का योग बनता है तब इस कुंभ का आयोजन होता है। ये परंपरा करीब 5000 से लेकर 50000 साल पुरानी है, क्योंकि 50000 साल जो हमें संदर्भ मिलता है वो वैदिक भाग में मिलता है, जो अपुरुषेय ग्रंथों का हिस्सा है। वहीं पर जो मनुष्य होता है वो मनुष्य अपनी संपूर्ण मनुष्यता के साथ एक तरह से अपने अंतर्मन के योग की ओर जाता है। तो इन दोनों योगों का संयोग होना एक अपने आप में बड़ी आध्यात्मिक घटना है। इस आध्यात्मिक घटना को हम दोनों तरह से देखें कि इसका खगोल विज्ञान से क्या संबंध है, एस्ट्रोनॉमी से क्या संबंध है, और मनुष्य के अपने भीतर की एस्ट्रोनॉमी क्या कहती है। तो ये एक ऐसा आयोजन है जो योग से कुंभ और कुंभ में योग, ये अपने आप में अद्भुत घटना है।